Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If today is your first time of watching my program, why not hit that subscribe button and the bell notification so that whenever I upload a new video, you will be the number one person to always watch it. And turning on the notification bell is very, very important. It enables you to know whenever I upload a new video so that you will always watch my video and enjoy all of them. And when you watch, please like the video, share it, and leave a comment down below. And today I want to make this video for young ladies who are preparing to get married, who wish to be married someday, and also for young men who also wish to be married someday. This video is for you. I believe after listening to me, you will find this video useful to yourselves. So let's get started. Before you start thinking of getting married or settling down, as some of us do say, you need to be prepared and know what you are entering into. Marriage is an institution which all women expect and are eager to attend at a certain point in their lives. And the moment we enter it, there is no looking back. Our lives, lifestyles, thought patterns, duties, and obligations change forever. So you need to be ready and prepared for it before entering. Yes. Before you start thinking of getting married or settling down with someone, you need to be prepared. Yes, marriage is a whole lot. You need to be ready. When I said ready, you need to be ready in all ramifications. The number two point is, do not be in a hurry to get married. You need to take your time and study this person you want to get married to. Don't just jump into marriage, because if you do, you will also jump out of it. The reason for studying him or her is to know if both of you are compatible or not. Many discover that they are not compatible after marriage, and the next option is divorce. That is the reason why we have many divorces here and there. Yes, you don't need to jump into marriage. You need to study this person, you need to study this lady, you need to study this man before you decide. Where third point is, marry based on love, not for material things. Make sure that this person you are getting married to loves you the same way you love him or her. Majority of young ladies today, if not all, base their marriage on material things, not minding if this person loves them or not. All they care about is that he must be rich, he must own a car and house. No. Do not marry based on material things. Rather, marry based on love. Besides, it is very good for you to marry a man or a woman you struggle with. Make your riches together. You will feel comfortable. Do you want to marry a man that is already married? Maybe when you step your feet on, why do you put your leg there? Do you know how much I bought that seat? Or you marry somebody that will go out for work or business. By the time he's coming back, you'll be afraid. Because if you marry a man that is rich and you are not doing anything, you don't have anything, he will not give you the total respect you need. So marry based on love. If you marry a poor man, both of you can make it tomorrow. Work hard. Follow him to make this money so that you will be enjoying it. You will feel comfortable, you will feel relaxed, and it's this money Not somebody who will give you money today. Tomorrow, when you want to ask, he will tell you, do you know how I suffered to get this money? You are only here to eat. I gave you money yesterday and you are asking another one. But if both of you make this money together, when you ask for money, he will give it to you because he knows that you also work hard to make this money. And when you are in your heart, you will feel comfortable. So ladies, be wise. Gone are those days when you marry a ready-made man and you feel happy in the house. Except if this man loves you. I'm not saying that ready-made men are not good. If he loves you in return, the way you love him is good. But if he doesn't love you, I bet you will never feel happy in that marriage. But if you marry somebody that loves you and you love him and he doesn't have money, you can work together and make money. So think, open your eyes and stop wasting your time. The next one is, do not be too selective. Many unmarried men and women we have today is as a result of being too selective. The person I am going to marry must be handsome. He must be young and educated. Yes, many young ladies especially are not married today. Not because they don't have a suitor, but they put themselves in that position. A spouse will come to you, and what you will say is that he's not handsome, he's not young, he's not educated. To ask him, what has education got to do with marriage? Marriage is a different institution. Education is a different institution. You will say he's too old. I am still young. He's too old. Let me tell you the truth. If you marry a young man or a man that is of the same age with you, both of you will be like cat and rat, except if he loves you. If you marry somebody who is a little bit older than you, you will enjoy your marriage. He will pet you because this person is matured in brain. He's matured in everything. But if you marry your age mate, it will just be like we are two little children that are of the same age are playing. You know, they can fight, they can play and fight at the same time. But if you marry somebody who is a little bit older than you, this person is more learned than you do, experienced than you. There are some certain things you will do, he will tolerate it. But that person that is of the same age with you will not tolerate. He will always complain. So stop this issue of he's old, he's not handsome, he's not educated. What has all this got to do with marriage? You need to stop this. If you love a man and he loves you, get married to him. Forget about all this material thing. There has nothing to do with marriage because marriage is a different institution. So be wise. Make sure that you have a profession or something doing before you start thinking of getting married so that you will be contributing something to your marriage and to also avoid being a liability to your partner. In fact, you can achieve a happy married life when you marry someone who truly loves you and the person loves you in return and you are contributing something to your marriage. Yes, you young lady that is describing how your husband should be. He will be tall, he will be handsome, he will be rich, he will have big house. If you see where ladies are discussing about the type of husband you will marry, you will laugh. You are looking for somebody that is rich, you too can be rich. If you want to make a happy marriage life, you need to have a profession. You need to have something doing. You need to be contributing something in your marriage, not being a liability. You are sitting down in your house describing the type of man you will marry. What will you also add to your marriage? You need to be doing something. Nowadays, every woman wants to be educated. Yes, you can be educated, but it is good for you to also learn a handwork. This will help you. You need to be doing something. Not every time you'll be asking your husband if you want to make your hair, darling, can you give me money to make my hair? If you want to buy ordinary pad, you ask your husband, Honey, can you give me money to buy a pad? If you want to buy the church card, he will give you. If you want to buy a makeup, he will give you. He's a woman being. It is also blood that runs in his flesh. So he's a woman being. When somebody asks you something too much, you are a human being, you also feel the pains. But if you are doing something, you'll be buying all these things by yourself, contributing a little in the family, and there will not be problem. Nobody will be disturbing each other. In fact, some of the successful marriage you see today is as a result of the woman, the wife, contributing to the marriage. So you need to have something doing before you start thinking of settling down, as this also will help you in your marriage. It will make your husband to respect you. It will make you to have your full respect. Even your husband will be talking about you outside. He will give you your respect, but when you keep demanding this, he will give to your parents, he will give to your unborn children. He's a woman being. So my dear young ladies, I hope you learned something from this video that I have just made now. You need to be ready before you start thinking of getting married. Do not be in a hurry to get married, and do not be selective. Marry based on love, not of material things. You need to have a profession before you start thinking of getting married. Yeah, I think I will end it here. I believe that you have understood something from what I said. And